Hello everyone, this is Leo from GeneratePress. In this video, we will be looking at the widget area available throughout GP and the options associated with them. Let's get started. The three modules we need for this tutorial are the Elements module, the Menu Plus module, which is needed to use the off-canvas panel, and the spacing module. Now let's head to the widget area. So here you can see all the widget areas that are available in GP and the WordPress core widgets that you can add to the widget area here. Let's start by looking at the top bar widget area. You can add as many widgets as you want inside a widget area, but normally you would only want either one or two in the top bar. So right now I have a navigation menu widget and a text widget. The menu selected here can be created using the WordPress menu builder. Now let's take a look. So here are our top bar widgets. Next, we will head to the customizer. Before we check out the top bar widget area options, I just want to mention that you can also edit the widgets here in the customizer with the live preview. Now let's go to Layout, Top Bar, and look at the options available. First, we have the top bar width option. We can also change the inner width. We also have the alignment option. So this option aligns the first widget you added. In my case, it's the navigation menu widget. Selecting left would swap their position. Selecting center would put them both in the middle. We can also change the top bar padding. Next, let's take a look at the header widget. The header widget is located in the site header and on the opposite end of the site logo or title. There are no specific options for this widget area. Now let's take a look at the off-canvas panel widget area, in which I have a GP logo added. In order to use this widget area, make sure you have the off-canvas panel activated. This is the reason why we needed to activate the Menu Plus module at the beginning. And you can see the widget here. Now let's move to the bottom and take a look at the footer bar widget area, which is right here. The most common usage for this widget area is again a navigation menu widget. Let's take a look at the options available. Again, we have the width and inner width, which controls the entire footer, including the footer widgets. Then we have the footer bar alignment option. Setting it to center will position the footer bar widgets above the default copyright field. Then, of course, we have the padding. Now let's move back up and take a look at the sidebar widgets. So we have right sidebar and left sidebar. You can find the options in Layout, Sidebars. The sidebar layout option allows you to change the layout for static pages. The block sidebar layout allows you to change the layout for post page, archives, and search results, etc. So we're on the post page right now, so it will be this option. The single post sidebar layout allows you to change the layout for single post or any kind of custom post type post. Then we have the widget padding option, which allows you to modify the space around each sidebar widget. Lastly, you can change the width of your sidebar using the sliders here. It's currently in an increment of 5, but we will be changing this to increment of 1 in the future version that we have the flexbox structure. Now let's look at the last widget area, which is the footer widgets. By default, there are 5 of them. This is another common widget area where the navigation menu can be used. We will head back into Layout, Footer for the options. The Footer Widgets option allows you to set how many footer widgets you want to display throughout the entire site. Right now I have 3, and you can go from no footer widgets to 5 of them. Then we have the padding options. So that changes the space around the entire footer widgets container. You can also change the padding specifically for mobile screens by using the mobile toggle. For the sidebar and footer widgets, there are also two additional methods which provides even finer layout control. So let's say if I want to use a different sidebar layout and a number of footer widgets for this single post here, we can use the layout metabox for this. So right now it's set to right sidebar with 4 footer widgets. We can go to edit post. In the layout metabox, you can see a sidebar layout. So let's say we were gonna go with left sidebar for this post with just 3 widgets. Let's take a look. So now this post has the left sidebar and 3 footer widgets. The third method of setting the sidebar and footer widgets layout is to use a layout element. This is useful when you want to edit the layout of multiple pages and or posts at the same time without going through every single layout metabox on each page or post. Again, the current option for pages in the customizer is set to right sidebar and 4 footer widgets. So that is the same for the login page. So we can go to dashboard, appearance, element, and add a new layout element. Give it a name like both sidebars and 2 footer widgets. We can choose both sidebar here, go to the footer tab and select 2 widgets, go to display rules, under location we can select page, let's just say sample page, add another rule, again say page, login page, hit publish, and let's take a look. So now you can see that the sample page has both sidebars with 2 footer widgets, which is what we've set in the layout element, same as the login page. While the privacy page still has the layout set in the customizer. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.